Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome to Tewkesbury Abbey for this week's lunchtime organ recital. Sadly, this is the last in our present series, our short series of recitals this summer. There'll be more next year, I'm sure, and hopefully it will be a full series back to normal. But today you're in for a real treat. It's wonderful to welcome James Lancelot to play for you today. James, as you know, was Master of the Choristers and Organist at Durham Cathedral for 32 years, and we're very fortunate that he decided to retire here to Tewkesbury, and he's very much part of the Abbey community. He's assembled a lovely programme for you today, and he's going to say a few words about the music. So without more ado, please welcome James Lancelot.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It's a huge pleasure to play once again in this holy and glorious building. We've got quite a variety of music this afternoon. I'm starting with one of the not so well known preludes and fugues of J.S. Bach. It's a piece which I think deserves playing more often, and I think one reason why it isn't is that there's, in the prelude, there is a descending sequence through a whole octave of arpeggiated diminished seventh chords, which is so long that it seems to defy any sort of logic. I don't normally rewrite J.S. Bach, but I have actually taken a hatchet to the prelude, and I think the result is a piece that will hang together in slightly better proportion. I would add that the enormous sequence doesn't occur in all the sources. Listening to CDs over the summer, I came across this set of variations by Rinck on the theme of Corelli. It's a theme which one seems to recognize, and I wonder if it's related to a folk song. You might recognize it. Rinck was, as it were, Bach's grandson in terms of tuition. Kittel was a pupil of Bach, and Rinck was a pupil of Kittel. But of course, by this time, music had moved on quite a lot, and at least one of the variations could easily be by Mozart. There's a theme and six variations, of which the last variation is extended. The next piece is a sort of reverse, because organists sometimes play arrangements of orchestral pieces, but in this case I'm playing an arrangement for the organ of a piano piece. In the days when you had to find somebody to blow the organ if you wanted to practice, and when the church was probably cold, a lot of organists had pedal pianos or pedal harpsichords at home. Schumann not only had one, but he actually wrote pieces specially for it, a series of sketches and a series of studies. This beautiful little study in A-flat is largely canonic in the right hand, and it's rather a gem. Moving on enormously to Paul Hindemith, he wrote only three sonatas for the organ. If only he'd written more for the organ. Each of them is different, and each of them is wonderful. It's quite discordant, brittle music. In a sense, you feel it oughtn't to work, but actually it's deeply human, and I think well worth a hearing. Don't be put off by the low opus number of the Durufle. Durufle was famously self-critical, and most of his music ended up in the waste paper basket. Alas, we don't know what or how much. The suite for organ has three movements, of which the Sicilienne is the middle movement. It's the Sicilienne, as its name implies, and it is really most beautiful, and comes from that wonderful period of French artistic creativity. Guilmant was famously prolific. Not always as selective as Durufle was, it has to be said, but at his best, he's well worth hearing. The theme of Handel is the theme from Lift Up Your Heads, O Ye Gates, in The Messiah. Guilmant quotes only the first four notes of it. In fact, it seems very honest of him to confess that he's taken a four-note descending sequence from another composer. But I think the reason is really that the whole piece is sort of imbued with the same spirit of glory as the Handel chorus. And finally, a piece that you don't want to try and process out of evensong in time to, because if the choir does that, they will fall like a pack of dominoes. Planyavsky was organist for some time of St. Stephen's Cathedral in Vienna. He's a leading Austrian organist and composer, and the piece does exactly what it says on the tin. I'll be very delighted to meet people afterwards, but because I'm vulnerable, if you could give me 2 yards distance, if you can remember what a yard is, please. And please, let's wear face masks. And finally, a lot of organ repertoire is based on Lutheran chorales. This recital is no exception. You will hear a Lutheran chorale, but you will hear it when you absolutely least expect it. So keep listening and enjoy.